As mentioned earlier, this particular example is not very rare. So, if we are patient enough, we can simply run a crude Monte Carlo estimation. Of course, if we run CMC with our normal value of R, which is 1 million, then it's likely that we'll get the boring zero estimate. So, we must take a bigger value of R. Since our code is vectorized, it generates all the normal variables at once, and therefore we need enough space in our computer's RAM to store these values. 1 million numbers isn't so large, but 10 to the power of 10 numbers is probably too much for a normal computer. One way around this problem is to simply run repeated CMC experiments where each time we use 1 million random variables, and just count the number of times each variable exceeds our threshold. The code to calculate our confidence interval is slightly uglier, but otherwise it works fine. Since this will take a long time, I'll bring in the progress bar defined in the TQDM package, and replace our main loop's range call by trange, so we can keep track of this long-running simulation and when it will end. Here, our CMC estimate is roughly as good as our CE estimate, though the CE estimate took less than a second to calculate compared to the 6 minutes of this estimate. It's often a good idea to use two or more different algorithms to estimate the same rare event probability. It's very easy to make a programming error, though if different algorithms give the same estimate for the probability, then we can be pretty confident in the result. My computer's CPU has 8 virtual cores, and only one is working when running this code. It's not so hard to get those other lazy cores working. Crude Monte Carlo is one of the so-called embarrassingly parallel algorithms, since there's nothing stopping each simulation occurring in parallel. I'll import the joblib library to handle the multiprocessing code. One rookie mistake when writing parallel Monte Carlo code is to accidentally use the same random number generator in multiple processes. So, instead of getting all of the unique random numbers that we wanted, we end up repeating some of them. One way around this is to use a different random number generator with a different seed for each batch of million samples. That's what this seed sequence code is doing. The next part takes our Monte Carlo code and runs it in parallel across the 8 cores. Lastly, we combine the results and construct confidence intervals, just as before. We end up with the same result, but about 5 times faster.